Pink slips in the glove box.
What?
Don, that was your car keys. Maybe just give him like some gum or something. You don't gotta go nuts. For the past 7 seasons, we've all been watching, trying to figure out what's gonna happen to Don Draper. I'm Gabe Hohreiter, and there are a lot of theories swirling around in the inner sphere about what we can expect from the finale. Some crazy, some genius. Obviously, they're all gonna be proven wrong when Matthew Weiner reveals it was just all an autistic boy's dream, which is how the show St. Elsewhere ended, for real.
I don't understand this autism thing, Pop.
But let's entertain them anyway. This is Hashtag News. So the penultimate episode leaves us with Don at the bus stop in Kansas. Betty's got cancer, Jones sold out, and Pete Campbell's headed to Wichita. Now there are exactly 56 minutes of screen time for Weiner and his team to wrap up this show. So let's take a look at some of the most popular theories of where this show will end. One theory is that Don's gonna head back to New York. Between the mother of his children dying and all the money he's been giving away all season long, he's not wearing a barrel or anything, but he's gotta have some cash flow problems at this point. So Don might go back to McCann to win back his job with a Don Draper pitch to end all Don Draper pitches. Now what could that be? Some are speculating that it might be the most famous real-world ad of the 70s, the I'd Like to Buy the World a Coke campaign.
I'd like to buy the world a Coke.
There have been lots of mentions of Coke this season, and it could be a foreshadowing of this climactic event. Or maybe he's just going back to New York to, well, kill himself by jumping out of a building that's tall enough to do the job. Like one of the skyscrapers he made his name in. We all know the famous shot of the falling man from the opening credits. That could be something that's been foreshadowed and planned from the very beginning. Do you ever think of that? Boom! Another hint is that moment where he touches the window in the skyscraper. Maybe he's testing its strength. Don't do it, Don! Now one of the most bizarre theories is that Don Draper is actually D.B. Cooper, a mysterious real-life figure who hijacked a plane for a $200,000 ransom in 1971, leapt out with a parachute over Oregon, and was never heard from again. Don has links to French Canada, as did Cooper. Cooper fell to Earth, like the figure in the show's opening titles. Don worked at a company called Sterling Cooper. DB sort of sounds like DD, Don Draper's initials. Maybe we're reaching. The list of coincidences goes on, but not for long. If it doesn't go that far, the signs may be pointing to Don just flat out dying in a plane crash. When season 7 begins, we see Don shaving in an airplane lavatory. He tells possible Angel of Death Nev Campbell, "I fly a lot." When he's at Megan's house in LA, he's watching Frank Capra's 1937 film Lost Horizon about plane crash survivors who end up in Shangri-La. Interesting, considering Don's constant search for paradise. Then, when Megan asks him what he's watching, he lies and says nothing. Also, outside of the premiere, there's an abundance of airplane imagery used in the promo materials for the show's final season. The prediction, then, would be a poetic death by plane crash for Don. As the Chicago Sun-Times points out, 30,000 feet in the air, somewhere that's neither here nor there, in limbo, where he's lived much of his life. And remember that opening sequence? Who says he jumped out of a building? Maybe he fell from a plane. Yeah, not just a hat rack. One Redditor had the idea that Draper may be suffering from neurosyphilis, the final stage of untreated syphilis, since he's basically the Wilt Chamberlain of ad executives. Symptoms include confusion, depression, hallucinations, all of which have plagued Don in recent years. In fact, the theory goes, syphilis has already done him in. Or maybe Don finds a second chance in the form that it came in years ago, when something happens like a car crash or a plane crash that sets him up to be able to adopt a new identity and start over. Hopefully, at least this time, he may have learned something from his mistakes. Some people think this is it, because the stolen identity thing hasn't really come up since like season 2, but it was brought up in the last episode, maybe to set up this ending?
You knew we'd catch up with you eventually.
A happier theory has Don Draper finally kicking alcohol, reconciling with Megan, and they all live happily ever after, and Duck Filup dies in a plane crash. Classic Duck. The penultimate episode of Mad Men ended with Don sitting alone at a bus stop in the middle of nowhere, holding onto his belongings in a paper bag. We won't know where the bus is heading until the finale, but we already know this. Wherever Don Draper's going,
I'm living like there's no tomorrow. Because there isn't one.
Lastly, but not leastly, hit subscribe for the latest updates on all your favorite stuff like Mad Men, Game of Thrones, The Avengers. Rice pudding is also pretty popular, I think. Is that just me? It's just me. I'm Gabe Hohreiter, and I actually have a theory that Matthew Weiner might end it like The Sopranos did in mid- Don't stop believing!